Hello and welcome to the new video of GPA tutorial. In this video, I'm going to talk about the many-to-many relationship. Many-to-many relationship is where one or more roles from one entity are associated with more than one role in another entity. In the previous video, we have covered the many-to-one relationship where we have introduced the teacher entity. Now I'm going to create the many-to-many relationship between teacher and student. Inside the teacher entity, I'm going to add the set interface for the students with two annotations. The many-to-many annotation with cascade persist and merge. Cascade type persist propagates the persistent operation from a parent to the child entity. Instead, the cascade type merge propagates the merge operation from a parent to a child entity. Then I added the join table annotation. It provides the name of the join table, teachers, students, and the foreign keys with the join column annotation, teacher ID for the teacher entity and student ID for the student entity. Let me add the getter and setter method for students. Before going on the target side, I'm going to create the add student and remove student methods for synchronizing the bidirectional association. In this case, I can be sure that both sides of the association are in sync. Now, on the target side, so the student entity, I had the set interface for teachers with just the many-to-many annotation mapping the student fields inside the student entity. In the same way, to make sure that both sides of the association are in sync, I added the add and remove teacher methods. Let's go inside the app class in order to try the new many-to-many relationship, creating a new instance of teacher assigning two new students. Let's run it and check the database. I have my teachers students table with the many-to-many relationship because I have the teacher ID related to two different student ID. In this video, you have learned how to use the many-to-many relationship with GPA, creating the relationship between teacher and student table. I hope you like and enjoy the video. Inside the description, you can find the link to the GitHub repository. And if you have any question, don't hesitate to add a comment inside the section below. And also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to be updated with a new video that I will upload. See you in the next video. Bye.